Hey Cacher, Derek here, Big Six Clan. Today we're going to be working out an idea that I've had for a 7-segment display and putting it into a birdhouse. Let's get started. All right, so as you can see, I'm not in the workshop today. I'm actually up in my office because I live in the Midwest and it is freezing outside, and my shop or my garage is like right at freezing, and yeah, I don't want to work in there today. But the concept that I was going to do anyways, I can show you kind of how I kind of worked through the idea of how I want to put this into a birdhouse. A couple weeks back, I did a show with Chad on Gadget Talk, and we were talking to Tricassius, and he was using these 7-segment displays that he was putting into what he called his magic blocks. And during the show, I was thinking, and I was like, wow, I wonder how I could put this into a birdhouse. And I kind of had a concept that I thought would be really cool, using kind of the same way that he was using, with the 7-segment displays and reed switches. Now, I don't have the reed switches that I'm actually going to put into the birdhouse here. I just have these right now, but for putting it into this proto board that I'm going to be using, these are going to be perfect for it. And it'll show you the kind of the concept that I'm going to be doing. Now, before I even start with putting the 7-segment display and wiring it all up, let me explain how the 7-segment display works. So, on the back of the 7-segment display, you have these 10 different pins. Each of the pins will power up one of the lines or the dot on this display. Now there's 10 of them and there's 8 different lines. So 2 of those are what's called the common or your ground, and that is your middle pin on the top and the bottom. Now that pin is connected in here, so you can only have to run the ground to just one of those lines. All right, so that's how that's lined up. So each pin will light up a line on the 7-segment display. So that was one part of it. Now we got to get power to it, and my original idea was using just a single AA, and that didn't really work because it didn't make the LED lights light up bright enough onto that 7-segment display. So I'm going to be putting a 2 AA battery pack onto it, but there's an extra thing that we have to do. Because it's a 2 AA, if I put this directly to that 7-segment display, it's going to fry it. It's got a little bit too much amp to it. So what I need to do is put a resistor in there, and this is a 100-ohm resistor. Now the way I'm going to put this 100-ohm resistor in is I'm just going to put it into the off the positive of the battery itself, and then just plug it into the protoboard. But what I'm going to be using is one of these solder sleeves, because it's just really easy. I'm just going to inline it right in there and solder it together, and then we're going to start wiring this up, how this will work. Let's get started. All right, so now I've got the resistor in line with the power there of the positive. And so that's just gonna, whatever I run through out of here into the proto board is already gonna have the resistance, so I don't have to worry about doing anything else. And so all I'm gonna do now is gonna connect it onto this proto board onto the top of it. Now, as you can see here on the proto board, you have a positive on the line here. So if I plug in the positive into one of these, it's gonna power up this entire line. Same thing with the negative or my ground, it's gonna do it all through here. So that's what I'm gonna do first. Let's go ahead and plug those in. So I have my positive with the resistor in one side, and now my negative, I plug into the negative there. So I'm just gonna kind of take these displays now, and I'm just gonna put it into the proto board itself, and just kind of have a little bit of a space where I'll be able to put in the reed switches and the other jumpers that I need to put into. So I'm just gonna kind of come in here and just kind of separate these just a little bit. All right, so now we have the displays in there. Now, real simple, I'm gonna take the reed switch from the positive, and I'm just gonna put it into a line over here to be able to power this display. So I'm just gonna kind of bend the reed switch just a little bit so I can come off the positive up top. And then I'm just gonna select the top hole up here and just put that in there right there. So now that reed switch here is plugged in here. And I'm gonna go ahead and work on this first display here. Now remember, I said that you're going to need to come off from the ground. So remember, I told you I'm going to have to come off from the ground itself and feed one of the commons into the 7-segment display. So I'm just going to simply just take one of these jumper cables that I have here, and I'm just going to plug it into the middle. So two over from the edge into that middle, and that's going to give me my ground into this 7-segment display. On the screen, you kind of see a diagram of how the pins are for the 7-segment display itself. But if you don't want to, if you don't have one of those and you're trying to figure out how to do this, you can very simply just kind of plug into the positive and just kind of touch each of the lines to see which one lights up. So my idea for this cache is to be able to run a magnet over the outside of the box somehow and hit the read switch, and that would light up one of these 7-segment displays, revealing one of the numbers for the combination. So before I can even put the number into the 7-segment display, I need to know what the combination is. So whatever the combination is, so let's just say it's going to be 1, 4, 7. So I'm going to need to make the 1, 4, and 7 on these 7-segment displays to be able to reveal that. And I'm going to be using the read switches, and then I just need to kind of make the numbers out on here. So I'm going to need to wire that up. All right, so I've got it wired up now for the 1, 4, and 7. And it's a really simple wiring itself, because all I'm doing is coming from the read switch, from the positive, and into the one of the lines. And where that line is, everything in that line is positive, so that's what I am feeding the 7-segment display. And on the other side, I just have a ground coming into the common, or the ground on the 7-segment display. So all I do now is just run the magnet over it. So you've got your 1, 4, and 7. And this is just a really simple concept of the way to be able to do this wiring. And I really can't wait to be able to put this into a birdhouse and kind of really see how this would really work with the combination and everything in the birdhouse itself. I think it'd be really cool. Now, another idea I had was to be able to use this as a redirector in a multicache. And so this would actually, you run your magnet over the redirector and it gives you the next set of coordinates. Just some other different ideas. Many different things inspire us. Like, I was getting inspiration from when I was doing that gadget talk, and I get a lot of inspiration from doing gadget talk. So I don't come up with a lot of these ideas myself, but I take what I see and I put my own spin to it. And that's what I really like seeing from you out there, is taking that spin that you've done on these caches that I've shown and putting your own spin onto it. I really love sharing those ideas, and I love it when you guys share those ideas with me. So please share your ideas with me that you've done from these caches. Would really love to see it. You can tag me on Instagram or on Facebook, or you can just go to my builders page, Behind the Cache Builders page on Facebook, and check that out and join. And if you're doing these builds, you can post them right on there. I would love to see them. But what other ideas would you like to see with the 7-segment displays? Really love to see it. So leave me a comment down below. The 7-segment displays and the solder sleeves and all these different, and the resistors, I have links for those down in the description, and those are affiliate links. So whatever, if you get those and you click on those, it really does help the channel, and I really do appreciate it. But hey, thank you for joining me today. But don't go anywhere. Go check out another one of these videos just right over here and find the story behind the cache.